Should the church accept trans people? Does God accept trans people? Today is Friday, October 1st, and let's find out together God's view of trans people and whether the church should be welcoming to people of the trans community. Now, we've been talking about some weighty and complex issues over these last 2 weeks, issues that are becoming part of our everyday conversations and experiences in our culture. So today we're talking about the bottom line. Should the church accept trans people? And does God accept trans people? Again, I'm going to lean a little into Dr. Preston Sprinkle's book, Embodied, to address these two important questions for us as Christians living in, but not of, our culture today. So let's start with God's view of trans people. Does God include people who vary in their gender in some way? You know, on Sunday, we looked at Genesis 1, 26 and 27, and saw that God created all people in his image, male and female, he created them, and they ultimately were created for the purpose of revealing God to the rest of creation. We also know from many places in Scripture that God loves and values people, that he uniquely created them to reflect him and to do the good works that he created for them to do. We also look to Jesus and his actions that prove God's love for people. John 3, 16 and 17 says, "For this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life." God sent his Son into the world not to judge the world, but to save the world through him. You know, Jesus took the punishment for sin for all people on the cross, and he offers all people forgiveness and life and relationship with him. We also see that God includes all kinds of people in his family: men, women, children, eunuchs, prostitutes, tax collectors, sinners, lepers, kings, beggars, and on and on. You know, God meets us where we're at. He loves us, and he transforms us to reveal more and more of his image in us. So should the church accept trans people? It seems like a no-brainer, doesn't it? Yeah, duh. Yet sometimes our stereotypes, our ignorance, or our fear prevent us from extending God's love, compassion, and grace to those who have experiences that are different from the majority. Accepting people doesn't mean that those people must have perfect beliefs about God or lived perfect lives. Our Christian communities are all flawed because they are made up of flawed, imperfect people who need forgiveness and are striving to be more and more like Jesus. You know, Christian discipleship is all about pursuing God and allowing him to restore his image in us. Discipleship includes inviting God to tell us who we are and who he wants us to be. And in order to begin the process of discipleship, we must first be accepted as we are. Dr. Sprinkle says that part of discipleship is learning to embrace our bodies as important aspects of our identity, learning to see them as gifts from God and part of how we bear his image in the world. Trans people need God's community to accept and include them so they can be surrounded by people who will journey with them, supporting them and encouraging them to be who God created them to be. If our church is not accepting the trans people, then, as Dr. Sprinkle puts it, our church has some serious issues it needs to sort out with Jesus. He says, if a trans person comes to our church, they should be welcomed with open arms and accepted. Not just accepted, but embraced, delighted in, listened to, learned from, honored, loved, cared for, and shown heavenly kindness saturated with compassion. Would a trans person be welcome in our church? Let me finish with one more quote from Dr. Sprinkle. As the number of trans people in the world increases, our churches should have more trans people, not fewer. Not because our ethic is weak or unclear, but because it is strong and holistic, true, courageous, compassionate, and humble. If people, especially marginalized and broken people, come into our communities, they should never want to leave. Now, so let's be a church where anyone can be a part of a community of Jesus followers who love one another well and shine the light of Jesus to a watching world who needs him too.